We just completed refueling our Takeuchi TL12 skid steer. I measured our log, small ends 10 inches. It's really the only end that really matters. The log is 13 feet long, and the bow, the curve in the log, is 5 inches. Doing Elvis. Pretty soon you're not gonna be able to get through there. Another glorious day on the homestead. I don't know if you guys can see this, but we're cutting bananas on the sawmill. I don't know what that curve is. I'm gonna have to measure that, but that log has a pretty good bend in it. Our goal is to cut some floor joists for our mill extension, some floorboards, and we moved our scarf joint beam off to the side over here. We need to cut another 8x10 to pair up with that. Well, we're gonna start by cutting this tree here, getting it out of the way. We got one more, and then we're gonna go back over to our log pile. Well, let's get to work. I tried to see if I could push that end down, but it's hitting hard on two of these bunks. And it really doesn't want to come down. If I pulled it down, either way, I'd end up with three bunks that I wouldn't be sitting on. So we're going to cut it and see what we get out of it. The pith from end to end basically is 5 inches. It's 5 inches off from each other, to the center of the log. So I'm not going to use it for anything structural, but we're going to cut it up. I also had to go through our lubricant lines were clogged, so I unclogged those. The way I did that on our HM130, Woodland Mills HM130 mills, is on the side of the water tank, you got a vent line on the top so it doesn't create a vacuum, so the water flows freely through the line. What I did is on the cap on the tank here, you got a pinhole. I put my thumb over that, block that, and try blowing through that line, and nothing would flow through it. So then I started disconnecting things from the bottom here. You got a little, looks like a grease zerk, but it's not, it's for water. But I started disconnecting the hoses, working my way back up to the tank every time it had a connection point. And I would blow through it, try to force air through it. And it was actually clogged inside the water tank. If you're using soap in your lubricant water, You got to make sure that you mix that up first in the water before you put it in the tank. I made the mistake when I first got the mill. I put the soap in the tank. I was just using dishwashing detergent. And I got a feeling that that's what clogged up the inside of the tank. That coagulated in the bottom and it clogged it. So I ended up having to, basically, I disconnected from this point here up. It blew into it, basically was able to dislodge whatever was in there, and now it flows freely. Let's get cutting. Today it's only supposed to go up into the low 90s. Be somewhat pleasant, at least it's not in the triple digits. With the bend in the log, that was the first cut we were able to make the entire length. The heat, the sun, plays havoc with our video equipment. Once it gets too hot, the camera likes to shut off. So I'm going to turn this 180. I'm going to put the flat side down. Looking for bugs. A lot of times they're between the bark and the tree. It's a heavy log. Once we get this mill deck completed, then we're gonna set up our mill. We'll have to build a platform and set up our mill extension. I didn't get the mill extension with the legs. I figured I could build it out of wood. Then I'm going to get this off these jack stands. So we'll basically be able to jack this up, put the tires back on it. I'm going to remove the tires, jack this up. Tires back on it, and we'll be able to pull it out of here. Put the whole mill, we'll set down on a stationary platform with the extension connected to it, so it will be level. Should stay level. We'll have to, we'll verify it. But has a I was just thinking. Thank you. One banana, two banana, three banana, four. Yeah. I remember when I was young. Yeah, banana split. We've changed the saw blade so the machine won't bog down and we won't end up with the waves in the board. And we rotated the log. So right now, the log is 6 1/4 thick. So I'm trying to get one floor joist out of it. And maybe we can get some floorboards. Okay, we'll flip it over. Don't need these. Yeah, trees like that that aren't straight. A lot of wasted time trying to get usable lumber out of them. Although we did figure out another use for some of the mill drop. We're going to use it for the vertical boards for some fencing for the animals, particularly the goats. Fairly heavy log. I have one more inch. I run out of gas. I hate these new gas cans. That was it for this can. We loaded up and started cutting another log, but it's when you start making small oversights. So I locked this in here, but I gotta set these backstops. I gotta slide them down and lock them in. Right now they're sitting up high and they're loose, so that log isn't true. But we did get another another, I don't know if you can see it. You can see that we did get another floor joist in for our extension. That's 40. That's going to give us another 42 inches, 3.5 feet on the end of this deck. And that will allow us to be able, when we put the extension on, we'll be able to walk around it. We got that out of the banana. Yeah. I used the blower to get all the sawdust off the deck. We ended up changing our blade today.